Okay, this video is about cross-coupling reactions, particularly catalytic cycles for cross-coupling reactions that are catalyzed by transition metals, and the key features that are common to these cross-coupling reactions. So we're going to take the example of palladium catalyzed cross-couplings. They're the most common, certainly, although there's other transition metals that can be involved in cross-coupling reactions. The mechanisms are very similar, and they all share sort of key features in common. So for these reactions, generally, we start off with a palladium zero complex. We've just drawn this out with some number of ligands. So we're being a bit vague here, but generally we'll have a stable resting state of that palladium zero species. It'll normally be an 18 electron species, and that will need to lose a ligand so that we can then bind to our first reaction partner. So the first step of most of these mechanisms is what's known as an oxidative addition reaction. Okay, so oxidative addition will get some kind of organic species that has normally a leaving group. So this will quite often be a halogen or what we call a pseudohalide. So things like triflate, tosylate, things like that. Something that polarizes that carbon X bond and can act as a leaving group. So what happens is a palladium in this first step gets oxidized, and that's why it's known as an oxidative addition. And this group adds to that palladium species by breaking that bond, and each half of this molecule now is bonded to that palladium. So we'll draw this out with a blue color now. So we'll have a palladium. Once again, we'll be vague about what ligands are present on that palladium. And then we've got the R group has been inserted as one new ligand for that palladium, and the X group is the other. So now, at this point, we've got a palladium 2 species. So as I said, this is why we call it oxidative addition. Okay, so that new palladium species is fairly reactive, and it will find in solution your other cross-coupling partner, which is normally some kind of organometallic reagent or something that can react like an organometallic reagent. And so this is polarized delta negative at the carbon group. And the next step we call a transmetalation. Okay, so transmetalation. So we're swapping the metal that it is attached to this R2 group is now being swapped for the palladium. And in the same step, we're going to now produce a kind of metal halide or metal salt of a similar type. So we'll draw this out in blue once again. So we're still at palladium 2 oxidation state, but now we've got this R1 group here and an R2 group and some number of ligands stabilizing that complex. So as I said, this is still a palladium 2 species. And it's also quite reactive. And so generally, in most of these cross-coupling reactions, we then get a final step to regenerate the active catalyst and to generate our cross-coupled product. So a product is going to be where we have a bond between R1 and R2. Okay, and that final step, the palladium 2 is being reduced down to palladium 0. So it's going to be called a reductive elimination. Reductive, because the palladium is being reduced, and elimination, because we're eliminating those two groups from the palladium center. And so that generates a cross-coupled product with that carbon-carbon bond that we've been trying so hard to make, and regenerates the palladium zero species that completes the catalytic cycle. So we go around again, and we get many turnovers of this catalyst to generate large quantities of our desired cross-coupled product. So that's the general key features of transition metal catalyzed cross-coupling reactions, particularly involving palladium. If you can understand those key features, they're present in most of the important cross-coupling reactions that you'll come across.